Here we go. Okay, so we're going to subtract 5x from both sides, which is not the thing that I would do, except you're not quite understanding when you try to solve these equations. You're not quite understanding what you're doing. You're just trying these random things. I'm not sure what the rationale is sometimes, but it seems almost random. Okay, I forgot to mention. So we had this review on the Friday, and we're just going to try again. Because we're confused. And I'm going to help you not be confused. I'm going to put those right there. Also, the rest of that 1.3 assignment, I'm going to let you turn that in tomorrow. Okay? I'll wait to enter it until tomorrow. And we're going to get a little bit of 1.4. So we're going to get some correction on 1.3, a little bit of 1.4. Okay? We're going to try again on those variables on both sides.
So, since I'm on Friday, I'm going to take a review. I don't know if you did that one check.
You never have to make it up.
You know, okay.
Okay, so let's talk about it. What would happen if I subtract 5x from both sides? Robert?
You would get -3x + 9 = -x - 7.
Okay, -5x - 5x. 2x minus 5x is -3x.
-3x + 9 = -2x. 2x - 7.
Okay. Thing that as I flip through those reviews that I can see you're having trouble with is understanding like what happens when you do a certain thing to both sides. All right, let's take this equation and let's add 5 to both sides. No reason why I just randomly picked to add 5 to both sides doesn't really help us except for to understand what happens to both sides in an equation when you do. Certain thing. I'd like to just tell us what would happen. What would we have on the left and right side when we add 5 to both sides? Well, that was just an example. Now I've rewritten it. We're doing something completely different. Now we're adding 5 to both sides.
I know.
Kurt?
So I have 7x?
Anybody have anything to say about that?
No.
No. Why no?
That's the right answer.
Okay, JC?
Because it wasn't 5x, you just added 5.
Yeah, what did I add? Again?
5.
5x?
No.
No, adding 5. Can I add 5 to 2x?
No.
Well, I mean, I could, but they don't combine, they don't become one term. Can I add 9 to 5?
Yes.
Yeah.
Into one term?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, 7x, but instead we have
2x
plus 14
equals 3x minus 12.
No,
3x
minus 2.
This is still really bugging me. How come is it you can't add like a regular number plus x, but you can multiply a regular number times x?
Yeah, adding and multiplying are related, but they're different things, okay? This is such I think about this all the time because it's a common mistake that people make year after year after year. It's a confusion. Not sure where it starts, but if you can continue to think of it or begin thinking about addition as the collecting of things that are the same, like going out and if apples and oranges and peaches grew all in the same orchard, I don't know if they do anywhere, but if they did, go out there and you get all the apples with all the apples, and you get all the peaches with the peaches, and the oranges with the oranges, okay? And we'll just say that we're not going to put oranges with apples, we're not going to put peaches with oranges, and we're not going to mix those things up. We're going to put all the things that are the same together in the same place. That's what it's like when we collect like terms, okay? The reason we can't combine certain terms is because they're not the same kind of thing. Apples and oranges don't go together. If I have 5 apples and 3 oranges, I do not have 8 of anything.
You have 8 fruits.
But then we lose a lot of information, right? Now 8 fruits could be pineapples, it could be peaches, now we don't even know that there were apples and oranges in the first place. Right? So to maintain all that information, we need to not erase what they are, not lose their identity. Saying 2x plus 5 is 7 terms, now we've lost all this information. So the reason why 2x plus 3 is not 5x, let's see what we're trying to do. Don't pay attention to your question, bud. Okay? 2x plus 3, we're trying to add them together. We're trying to like move down the number line. But here I have 2x, which is x plus x, okay? An x and another x, two of them. Here I have plus 3, which is really plus 1, plus 1, plus 1. So can I add these x's to these 1s? Can I take an x and a 1, put them together, make 2 or something?
No,
it's just they're not the same thing. They're different things altogether. They're like apples and oranges. Okay, so why can we multiply these things? Before I answer that, let's talk about what multiplication means. Okay, if I say 3 times 4, right, then I'm gonna use this to explain something like 3 times 2x and why this is 6x. Right? 3x plus 2, or 3 plus 2x is not 5x, or 5, or anything like that. What does 3 times 4 mean?
We're doing 3 4s.
Three fours or four threes. What are we doing for these three fours and four threes? We're adding them together, okay? So let's say we take, let's have 3 4s because it's going to help us over here. 3 4s. 4 plus 4 plus 4. That is what 3 times 4 means, right?
Mm-hmm.
You can add all these together, right? You get 12. Here, I'm not trying to like combine the 3 with the 2. But think of it that way. It's not like that at all. The 3 and the 2x. They're different things, okay? The 3 is just telling you how many of these to add together. So if I add 2x plus 2x plus 2x, now I see 3 times 2x for what it really is, just adding up a bunch of x's. Can I add up a bunch of x's? Because they're all the same thing. I can, because they're the same thing. They're all apples, they're all oranges, they're all peaches, whatever they are, they're all the same thing. There's two of them here, two of them here, two of them here. I could write it out really long if I want to. 2x's plus 2x's plus 2x's is 6x's. And then 3 4's makes 12. But if I try to add 2x plus 3, if I try to add them, put them together, combine them, sweep them together into the same pile, it doesn't work. They don't go together and make 5 of anything. Okay? Think, when I'm adding, are these things the same kind of thing? Can I put them together? Say that there are 5? In this case, we can't. There's not 5 in anything. There's 2 of these, there's 3 of these, and we're done. If I have 5x plus 7 plus 4x minus 3, well, these guys are the same. I can add 5x's and 4x's and have 9x's. And I can take 3 1s away from 7 1s because they're both 1s. When I take 3 1s away from 7 1s, I have 4 1s left. But then I'm done. 9x's and 4 1s cannot be combined together. I'm just like, opposite. Well, they're actually the same magnetic fields. They cannot, they repel each other, they can't go together, they're not the same.
Like when a magnet and another magnet can't put them together.
Oil and vinegar.
Oil and vinegar, yeah, that's good. They are different, they have different characteristics, they behave differently, and they just don't mix. You can throw them together and mix them, but you start to see the little oil bubbles come, and I think the oil floats to the top.
No, it's
the oil sinks to the bottom. Wait, did you say oil and vinegar? What's?
Like,
it's
vinegar. Baking soda and
oil and water.
Vinegar.
Oil and vinegar separate too. You like mix it up and pour it real quick.
Yeah, baking soda and vinegar
explode. That's not what we're looking for. We're looking for things that don't go together. Like oil and vinegar, oil and water, things that are different. The thing that's different about those things is they have different density and they cannot
exist in the same place.
Smoothie separates, right?
Water and alcohol.
That, well, honey and syrup. All right, let's stop this now. All right. So, if we add 5 to both sides, this is what we get. So let me go off.
Sorry, shush.
Okay. Now let's see. We take 2x plus 9. Equals, well, we're working with 7 gonna tell you to do something. You might think you did it. It'll turn out trickier than you think, but many of you are trying it over and over and over, and it just doesn't work very well. Okay, I want you to divide both sides by 2. Before I just call on somebody random and get maybe the correct thing, which would help everybody understand, or the incorrect thing, which may just confuse everybody further, I am going to just talk about it up here, Carter. Carter. Power. Why would someone choose to divide both sides by 2? Let's just start with that. Why would they think they should do that? Yes?
Their teacher told them to.
Yeah.
Because you have 2x on one side,
right,
and then you have 3x on the other. And so because it's 2x, you want to try and get x by itself.
So they've seen 2x before. They know that they've divided by 2 at that point to get 1x. And forward from there. If you're doodling rather than taking notes, then I highly recommend that you take notes because, well, it really takes some notes. Okay, now, hands down. Hands down.
No, this is actually a good question.
Question. Okay, question.
Okay, so if you actually solve that problem, you could do either.
Wait. No, that's not a question.
I know. It's confusing.
After this, then please ask your question, okay? I don't want to get sidetracked. So someone might divide by 2x because they see the 2x, or they might be divided by 2 because they see the 2x. Whenever they've seen 2x, they've divided by 2, or many times before when they've seen a 2x, they've divided by 2, and it's been the right thing to do. Okay? Now, is dividing by 2 the wrong thing to do here?
No.
Why is it not the wrong thing?
Because it can be done.
It can be done.
But then it leaves you with a messy number of 3.
So look at these two. Was subtracting 5x the wrong thing to do?
No.
But it confused Avery. Why would I do it? Right? It's not a good idea, but it's not wrong. Why is it not wrong? How did I make sure I didn't do this incorrectly?
Because you added it with like
terms. Okay, I made sure to combine it with like terms. Mm-hmm. And I also made sure with this equation to do the
same thing on the other side.
I do the same thing to both sides. It's fine. It's still equal. It's still just as true as it started out as, but it's just silly. It's kind of silly.
Worthless step.
So is this adding 5 doesn't really get us any closer to knowing what x is. Okay, here, turns out dividing by 2 doesn't get us any closer to knowing what x is. It turns out it's really quite messier than it was to start with. If I'm going to divide by 2, I need to do the same thing to both sides, which means everything on this side gets divided by 2, and everything on this side gets divided by 2.
Oh.
Okay. Everything.
So you get 1x and...
2x divided by 2 is
1x. Yeah, 1x and then...
9 divided by 2 is...
4.5.
3x divided by 2 now is nuts. Let's say 3 halves of x.
Well, I just put 1.5 because it's half of 3.
So it's 3 halves. X plus 9 halves equals 3 halves, x minus 7 halves. Who likes that better than what we started with?
I like decimals better.
I don't. I like decimals.
I'm asking about an opinion between decimals and fractions. I'm asking who likes this equation, decimals or fractions, more than the original equation.
No.
Not
really.
Nope.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Go ahead, you can get it.
Okay.
Everybody knows you're dropping.
Mineral water.
All right. So there's all this stuff that I see being done almost randomly. It's hard for me to know why you do a certain thing, but it seems almost random. And a lot of times it's this thing right here, dividing by 2 or dividing by 3, but you don't realize that if you were to do that at that step, it would create quite a mess. All right. So I'm going to try and help you understand what the cleanest steps to take are, all right? The shortest route to the solution. I'm going to teach you shortcuts. I'm going to teach you
the way to do it.
The way that I think is the fastest, but also that relies on you to understand what we're doing. Okay. So the first thing I would say is let's cancel the variable on both sides. On one of the sides. doesn't matter which one. But there is definitely a choice that I made. And that would be when I can't, well, first of all, how would I cancel the variable? What does that mean? Cancel the variable on one of the sides, Robert?
Probably by subtracting 2x on both sides.
So by subtracting. You want to subtract or add if it's a negative. I want to add to cancel that out on one of the sides. Okay? So you could subtract 3x to cancel the variable on the right side or subtract 2x to cancel it on the left side. I would subtract 2x because what happens is...
With the 3, you get negative.
If I were to subtract 3x, I would get a negative x, and I just don't like that. It's not any more correct. I just like to have a positive x.
That was my question.
What's the big deal?
I was wondering why, we could do plus 7, and then plus 7, you get, 16.
14.
I said... Plus 7, 16.
Yeah, you can do either of those, and they're both 100% correct and great to do, because they do cancel out a number on one side, which is helpful. The reason why I suggest, it's not mandatory that you do this, of course, the reason why I suggest that you cancel out a variable on one side is because then you can choose to have a positive x, either way you go. So if I cancel out the variable on side first, I can make my x wherever I wind up having x's left over on the right or the left for them to be positive. Does that make sense? I can leave them positive rather than negative. Okay. So no talking. Talking is not helpful. Not 3x. 3x minus 2x is just x minus 7.
Yes. Okay. Yes, it is.
Well, now we don't have variables on both sides. We have variables on one side.
So now we have an equation.
Well, we have an equation that looks more normal.
Okay, because
it's an
only one thing on the other side.
Yeah, just a number on this side. That's a good thing.
Yeah, okay, now I get this.
So now that we've canceled the variable on one side, it seems to be the natural thing to do next.
Add 7 on both sides.
So let's, this step is going to be kind of long, but cancel the number, let's say the constant, on the side with the variable. The side that now still has a variable on it, let's cancel the constant that's added or subtracted to it. Okay. The last thing we would do, we won't do it in this one, but we would divide or maybe multiply by the reciprocal at the very last. So we're going to cancel out this negative 7 by adding 7. We get 16 equals x, and x is 16.
Oh, I got that in my other one. I had a negative.
Just had that.
Yeah, I got negative
16.
I got
negative
16.
That was
in here. Well, zip it. I don't care.
Okay. So cancel the variable on one of the sides. Now only one side will have a variable. And really, it's just a two-step equation, which we've done many times before. But cancel the constant that's added to the variable now, and if you need to divide or multiply by the reciprocal, you're at the end. Yeah, get it.
What does the W
of
the slash mean?
With.
Oh. I thought that meant without.
Yeah.
W slash O means without.
Hmm.
Okay, let's give this a try. You guys try 5x plus 7 equals 3x minus 11.
Can we just solve it this time?
I just wanted to straight solve it. I was trying to point out to you how you want to have some kind of a strategy before you just start doing random stuff. So number one, what was the number one thing I'd recommend that you do?
Cancel the variable.
Cancel the variable, right? By adding. Whichever it takes. And you can do it on either side, it doesn't matter. One way will give you a negative leftover, negative variable. If you do it the other way, it'll be a positive.
This makes so much more sense now.
Good. So, again, the step one and step two are not algebra law. They're just my recommendation. They happen to be the steps that I follow, because you're naturally going to follow some kind of a pattern when you're solving these problems yourself. I could subtract 7 right now from both sides. That would be a good idea. We cancel out the constant number of the sides. I could add 11. I can subtract 3x. I can subtract 5x. I could do something that's really complicated, like divide by 3 or divide by 5. But the dividing by 3 or dividing by 5, I think, just makes a big mess. I would just avoid it. It's legal. You could do it, but I would avoid it. I would not divide until both sides look a little simpler.
So with all this stuff, we would get the right answer.
If you get the right answer by doing things on both sides, do it.
Yeah, so like dividing by both sides, you could technically.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. You would.
Okay. Well, yeah.
But
that's,
it would be. Ugh.
But you told us to like not take the, like from the Nemo thing.
Nemo!
Yeah. So the going over the trench would just be like, I don't know, I'll plug a 2 in there. Now that didn't work. I'll plug a 3 in there. Right. Turns out to be worse than you thought. You thought it would be easier, turns out to be a lot harder. The going through, like, you want to swim through the trench, but you don't want to crash into the walls unnecessarily. Right? That would be kind of like dividing by 5 on both sides. Making it harder than it needs to be. It's better to practice this algebra stuff, doing the same thing on both sides, but it would be, you want to do it in the least painful way as possible. So, my recommendation, I'm just going to show you the steps that I would follow. I'm going to cancel the variable on one side in a way that leaves positive variable, okay, rather than negative. If you did it a different way, but you wind up at the same place as I do, you did fine.
Great.
I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides because it leaves, the only reason I'm doing this first is because it leaves with me a positive 2x rather than a negative.
Yeah.
If you subtracted 7 on both sides, you did just fine. If you added 11 on both sides, you did great. If you subtracted 5x from both sides, great as well. Now I'm gonna cancel out the constant on the side with the variable. Here's the variable. I'm gonna not have this constant on this side anymore. Negative 11 minus 7 is negative 18. Divide by 2. Okay, x equals negative 9.
So
good.
Yay!
Yes.
Did we get a point because I got it right?
We should, because that was
yield
so
of satisfaction.
Why did that?
Good about doing something.
Stuart?
Yeah.
Have you ever been to the Field of Screams?
Yeah.
Okay. This conversation is over.
They probably named it after
him. It didn't make any sense.
They did not make any sense.
See how we do. We can get extra credit on this.
Guys, solve it really fast.
Moving through the trench just means doing algebra, which means doing the same thing to both sides. Trying to swim over the trench means just plugging numbers into x and seeing if it works. Which turns out not to be a good idea. Okay. Okay, there are 4 ideas that are equally as good as each other right now, but there is one that I would do. What did you do first?
Variable.
Robert?
Subtracted 5x on each side.
That's the same thing I would do, but it's not any better or more correct than anything else. Subtract 5x because now we don't have any variables on this side, okay? On this side we just have a 3x, I like that, I like a positive variable. Plus 11 equals negative 4. Okay. Now at this point, you could like subtract 3x from both sides, but that would be kind of weird. That would be just kind of making an extra step, because you're just kind of having the x's on the left side now, and the next step you have x's on the right side. You could add 4 to both sides, but let's see what would happen then. I would have nothing here and everything over here. But that, we don't want that. We don't want everything over here, just 0 over there. Because we're just kind of have to do some extra number of steps.
Yeah.
Instead, what should we do?
Minus 11.
Okay. Adding 4, not wrong. Just doesn't get us much closer to the solution. 3x equals negative 15, and now what, Robert?
Divide 3x each side.
3x?
Yeah. No, 3. Or divide 3 on each
side. Yeah, if I divide by 3x, I get 1 here. And then I get x in my denominator.
Okay, well,
equals negative 5.
Negative 5.
11 plus 4 is 15.
You can't.
five. Watch out for the negatives.
I got five. I got five.
Quiet in a minute, that's just gonna cause friction, it's gonna cost us time, and that's why we have trouble getting through what we could get through. You guys are capable of a lot, but you're not living up to it. Alright, now, like all the same ideas apply here, alright? We're just gonna have another variable, but then we're gonna decide which one to solve for. We'll solve for that one. Let's just try it, a simple one like 5x plus y equals 12. And I'm going to want you to solve for y. All that means is I want you to get y by itself on one side. I want you to get y by itself on one side.
Want us to solve for x2?
I don't know.
Just y.
Can we solve for x2 if we need to?
I don't think I can
do
this.
Just y.
What?
How do
we
do that?
Solve for y just means get y by itself on one side. Get it so that y is the only thing on one of the sides of the equation, and whatever's on the other side is what y is.
Got it.
All right. Can we get y by itself on one side? Can we cancel out the things that are not y?
I don't know.
And then have y by itself.
How do you cancel out x?
Robert?
Can you divide by 5 on each side?
Let's see what's going to happen if I divide by 5.
Okay,
now listen.
Okay, x plus y.
Listen. If you divided by 5, that would be the kind of thing I would do if I was trying to get x by itself. I don't care about x. I have no desire to see x happy and healthy. I don't care about x. I want y by itself on one side. Okay? If I were to divide 5, that's motivated by something like getting x by itself. I would have y divided by 5, 12 divided by 5. Right? If that's what I need to do to solve for y, then great, but it doesn't really get me much closer to having y by itself. Right? We have y here. We want to have it by itself, but it's added. 5x is being added to it. So how do I? Well, 5x is clearly the thing that is not y. It's stopping y from being all alone like it wants to be. So how do we get rid of that 5x?
You subtract 5 and
subtract
5. Yes, subtract 5 by 5. 5x by 5. And then you
what's 5x minus 5?
You get 0x.
No, you get 1x.
No, you get x.
You just get x.
It's subtraction. So therefore, you get
5x
but that's
minus 5.
You get x.
But you can't do it.
This is the same thing that Dalton asked, and then we had this big conversation about.
You
what's 5x minus 5?
You can't do it.
Oh, you 5x minus 5x.
Okay.
And then you get a 0x.
I don't write this down just to be a jerk or something. It happens all the time. People just subtract 5. When they subtract 5 from here, they just like make the x go away, and then they subtract 5 from 12, which that wasn't right. If you subtract 5x, though, 5x minus 5x is 0x. What's left on the left side?
Y.
Just a y. And I'll just subtract 5x. I can't combine them. They just it's just 12 minus 5x, and we've solved for y. We don't know what number y is, but as I said many times, solving for y just means getting y by itself. Y is by itself, 12 minus 5x.
I see.
What's that?
No. Such a lot of words.
I don't know why we're packing up. I didn't give you any indication that you should do so. Let's try one more time. But we're going to change it up a little bit. Now let's solve not for y. Remember to solve for y, just subtract 2x from both sides. Let's solve for x. And if you're having trouble, just think of y as a number, because you know what? That's what y is. It's a number.
I know what it is.
If it was the number 20, right, you would do something.
Is this right?
A particular set of steps. You're solving for x.
Why do you have to be so confusing?
Solve for x. When x be by itself, so just like if this was like the number 20, we would do the same thing. What's that? 2x plus 20 equals 3. What would you do with 20?
Minus
20. So we would the same thing. Minus y on both sides.
And then we get
2x equals 3 minus y. What would you do to get x by itself?
Divide
if you subtract
x,
divide by 2, divide everything by 2, x equals 3 minus y over 2. It doesn't look pretty, but that's what it is. Have a good day. Bye.
No.